Some students are already back in the classroom in San Benito County. Action News 8 reporter Alani Latang is live in Hollister tonight with a closer look at how the school year is going at Spring Grove School.
Yeah, Erin, we spent some time over at Spring Grove, and it was interesting seeing kids back into the classroom for the first time. But what teachers are saying is that they're really liking having to see their children's faces, see their emotions. But really, it's about being able to fully support their students now.
What makes it not fair is some kids will survive no matter what, but some kids can't.
At Spring Grove School in Hollister, being back in the classroom gives students all the support they need, whether that's extra help after school or not having to deal with internet problems.
It kind of leveled the playing field, and everybody has a fair chance to succeed now.
Spring Grove does in-person classes Monday through Thursday. They have 740 students, K through 8th, split into two groups. One group of students goes to school for 3 hours in the morning, then a second group comes for 3 hours in the afternoon. There is a disinfecting team that cleans between the groups. On Fridays, everyone learns from home. It's a plan they put into action last summer.
There was a big number of our staff, and there was a large percentage of parents who were really pushing for this. We just had agreed in August that once we got to that point, we were going to do it. And so there was just kind of no turning back.
Once San Benito County previously hit the red tier briefly, the school opened in October, going steady since.
If nothing else matters, just seeing them come on campus and be excited. Most of us don't just teach to give information. Most of us love to see the aha moment from a kid. And even though I don't see their mouth drop open and I have to read their eyes, I can tell when they get it.
Right, and so this principal at Spring Grove School, says that about half of their staff have been vaccinated with their first dose. More are expected this weekend and into the week. Reporting live in San Benito County, I'm Alani Latang, KSBW Action News 8.